Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So we've already seen what is a Pelton turbine, and we've seen the derivation, the construction part of it. We've taken few numericals on it also. Next, we'll move on to the specific speed. We'll see the definition, we'll see the mathematical formula for it, and we'll have some numericals on it then. Specific speed is denoted as NS, N subscript S. So specific speed, it is a term which we generally see in, when we study turbines. You know, it is used only for comparison purposes. So specific speed, I'll tell you the definition. It is the speed of a geometrically similar turbine which is developing a power of 1 kilowatt when it is working under a head of 1 meter. So I'll tell you once again, speed of a geometrically similar turbine. When I say geometrically similar, it means similar in all the aspects, like the geometry, the vane angles and everything. It is similar in all the aspects, and it is generating a power of 1 kilowatt when it is working under a head of 1 meter. That is how you define specific speed. So there's one mathematical formula available for it. We'll write the formula and then we'll take few numericals on it. So the formula is NS is N under root P upon H raised to 5 by 4. So the derivation of this formula is beyond the scope of the syllabus. So we'll just have to memorize this formula and take numericals directly. So the formula for specific speed is N under root P divided by H raised to 5 by 4, where N is the speed RPM, P is the power, and H is the head. And mind you, the power has to be in kilowatt, H has to be in meters. So just by looking at the specific speed, you can decide how efficient or how good a turbine is. So there are specific speeds available for different turbines. Like, we have a range of specific speed for Pelton turbine, we have a range for Francis turbine, we have a range of specific speed for Kaplan turbine. So I'll write out the range for each of the turbines, and specific speed tells you how much power it can develop. So the range is somewhat like this. Pelton, the specific speed range is 10 to 35. Francis turbine, the range is 50 to 250, or around 300 sometimes you observe. For Kaplan turbine, the range is 300 to 1000. So this is the range of specific speed. Specific speed is just used for comparison purposes when you are having two similar turbines. And if you want to compare the turbines, which turbine is more efficient, which one is generating more power, then you compare their specific speed and you come to know how good the turbine is, or relatively which one is better. So let's see few numericals on specific speed now. So I'll read out the numerical once again. There's a Pelton wheel which is having a diameter of 2.5 meter which is operating under the following given conditions. So the available head is 300 meter. The speed is 300 rpm. The coefficient of velocity is 0.98. Blade friction coefficient is 0.95. Blade angle is 165. The diameter of the jet is 20 centimeter. Mechanical efficiency is 0.95. So we have to find two things. First is the hydraulic efficiency, and next is the specific speed of the turbine. So first we'll calculate the hydraulic efficiency and then we'll go for specific speed. Since the value of diameter and RPM is known, we can calculate the velocity of the blade, that is the wheel, that is pi dn by 60. We've got the value of u. Now next, let's calculate the velocity of jet. Now since the angle of deflection given is 165 degree, so the angle phi, that is the angle of vane at the tip, which will be 180 minus 165, which is 15 degrees. Angle of deflection is 165, so you get the angle phi as 180 minus 165, which gives you 15. Next, let's calculate the discharge, that is Q. Discharge is nothing but area times velocity. The area or the diameter of the jet is given, so area can be found by pi by 4 d square, and the velocity we have already calculated. The diameter of the jet is 20 centimeters, which is 0.2 meter. Now since we've got the value of u, we've got the value of v, we've got the value of q, let's use the formula of hydraulic efficiency. We've already derived that formula, hydraulic efficiency for Pelton wheel. So this is the formula. If you remember, we've already seen this formula, we've already derived this formula, so let's use it directly over here. So the hydraulic efficiency formula for Pelton wheel is 2 times u, v minus u, 1 plus cos phi divided by v square. We've already calculated the value of u, that is the blade speed, v, that is the speed of the jet, phi already we have calculated, that is 180 minus 165, 15 degrees. If you substitute all these values in your calculator, you'll get the value of hydraulic efficiency as 0.981. Now we've got the hydraulic efficiency. Next is, we'll move on to the overall efficiency. The formula of overall efficiency is, we already know overall efficiency is nothing but hydraulic efficiency into mechanical efficiency. The value of mechanical efficiency is given in the question, which is 0.95, and the value of hydraulic efficiency is I've just calculated, which is 0.981. So multiplying these two values will give you the formula of the value of overall efficiency. So the overall efficiency is 93.19%. So the first part of the question is over, which was to find the value of hydraulic efficiency and overall efficiency. We've already calculated that. Next, we'll move on to calculating the value of specific speed, which we've already seen the formula of specific speed. So up to this part, we've already seen numericals on this part. We've seen numericals on Pelton wheel. And the next part that we'll be calculating is new, that is the specific speed. So before you go for calculating specific speed, you should have all these things with you. That is the value of the RPM, the power generated, and the value of H. As we can see here, we know what is the RPM, we know what is the head, but we don't know power.
So power can be easily calculated. The power output has to be calculated first. So overall efficiency is nothing but power output upon power input. So power output we'll calculate, and power input is nothing but the power that we get from the jet. So the power input is nothing but rho gqh. We already know that formula, and the value of rho is 1000 for water, the value of g is 1000, the value of g is 9.81, the discharge we've already calculated, which is 2.36, and the head is given as 300. So once you multiply all these values, you get the value of power. So you get the value of power as 6478.32 kilowatts. So now we know the power also, we know the head available. So let's substitute and get the value of specific speed. So substitute the value of power, the value of N and H in the given formula, you get the value of RPM. You get the value of specific speed, which comes out to 19.34. So the value of specific speed is 19.34. That's all about the numerical. Now let's move on to the next question. So I'll read out the question once again. A Pelton wheel is to operate under a head of 25 meters at 200 rpm. So the discharge is 9 meter cube per second. The efficiency of the turbine is 90%. So when the question says efficiency, it means overall efficiency. The overall efficiency is 90%. Calculate the power generated by the turbine. So we have to calculate the power and also the specific speed of the turbine. So we know the overall efficiency, let's calculate the power generated. So overall efficiency is power output upon rho gqh, that is the power input, and once you multiply overall efficiency with rho gqh, you get the value of power as 1986 kilowatts. And since we've got the power, we'll use the formula of specific speed and get the value. After you substitute these values and get the answer as 159.4. And don't forget to write the unit of specific speed. Since it is speed, it has to have the unit of RPM. So the unit of specific speed is RPM, and the magnitude comes out to 159.46. So that was all about specific speed, the concept and the numericals. So, thank you.